I still can't believe you said that to the waiter.
What? All I asked for was a cheddar cheesecake.
The look on his face almost made me choke on my water.
You'd think for a cheese-based dessert, they'd have a flavor for one of the most common cheeses.
I know, right?
Cheddar.
So this was fun.
It certainly was.
I guess this is where we part ways.
For now, but I'll be sure to see you tomorrow.
I'll catch you later.
Good night. Still had your coat. I was just coming to bring it back.
Look out!
Run!
Security measures have significantly increased. A curfew has been put in place for 9 p.m., with non-essential buildings being locked off after that time. And now, to end the program, we have a very special guest. After enduring a terrifying tragedy, this brave survivor has decided to share her story. Please welcome Alice Gordon. How are you doing, Alice?
I'm okay.
That's good. Now, do you think you could tell me what happened that night?
Well, it was very dark that night, and I was walking back to my room when I heard someone behind me.
Was it that madman?
No, it was Bob, the guy who took me out to dinner the night before.
I see. Take your time. I know this must be hard for you.
This doesn't seem right. I mean, it's too soon for her to be doing something like this. I mean, look at her. She's petrified.
All right. I don't want to overwhelm you, so I'll just ask you one last question. What did the killer look like?
He was dressed in all black, blending right into the shadows. And he had this mask. It was just plain white, but his eyes peered right through into me, and I just...
Okay, that's enough. Wes, turn the camera off. This interview's over. I told you she wasn't ready for this.
Sorry, I just thought it was best to get the story out there while it's still fresh in everyone's minds.
Yeah, but it's still fresh in her mind, too.
Can someone get the door?
Sorry, I forgot the code to the door there. How's Alice holding up?
Not too well. I still can't believe she has to stay here until her parents get back from Europe, and Penny kind of put her through the ringer with her questions, too.
Of course she did.
Oh, hey, Tommy.
What's up, Wes?
Listen, we were all just about to leave, actually.
What? I'm not going out there! No!
Hey, why not?
He could be out there again, hiding. I can't take any chances.
So then just don't leave.
That's not a bad idea, actually. We can stay down here tonight, and tomorrow I'll walk you back to your room.
Whoa. What do you mean, we?
Come on, man.
So, who's gonna stay the night? Well, then, it's settled. We're spending the night in the studio.
I mean, Chuck is just such a great guy, you know?
No, actually, we don't know, because we don't even know what he looks like.
Yeah, we've never met him, because you've never introduced us.
Well, for your information, he's great.
Do y'all really believe Alice's story?
Yes, 100%. What's the matter with you?
Yeah, what the hell, man?
Not saying that Boblin killed or that Alice did it. Just hear me out. Seems pretty suspicious that, you know, some guy with a white mask on would draw suspicion. It's like saying, you know, hey, look at me. I'm a creep.
So what does that have to do with anything?
It just seems like a little bit of fiction to put in our story, you know? Maybe it's some trauma blocking or... maybe she wants attention brought to herself.
That's messed up, man. How can you even say that?
Whoa. I'm just saying my opinion. You know, the way I see it, Bomb Killer probably one of those construction workers out there.
I'm gonna get some fresh air.
Yeah, I'm gonna go to the bathroom.
That must be Tommy. He probably just forgot the code again.
What is it?
There's gotta be some kind of joke. Some kind of sick joke.
The only one who could even think of pulling something like this is you. So no, I don't think it's a joke.
Still think it's some kind of construction worker?
It could be, but I'm starting to come around. Maybe we should call for help.
That's a good idea. There's still no reception. The stupid basement is blocking my service.
What's going on?
He's here. We have to get out of here.
About that.
What? Why are you saying that?
Well,
because of the lockdown, and probably because of a mix of the age of this building and the construction that's going on outside, the building is also locking us in here.
What?
How do you know that?
I tried to sneak Chuck in here earlier. The doors wouldn't open. I didn't think anything of it before, but then again, I didn't know he'd be trapped in here with a madman.
Really? All of them?
Yeah, I tried everything to get him in here.
Alright, so we just stay in here. The doors are locked, so he can't get in.
But he obviously knows that we're in here. He could definitely break in if he wanted to.
We need to find a signal, because we can make a call somewhere in this building, and then we can all... Oh my god, wait. Tommy's still out there!
And it sounds like we need to go out there in pairs. That way we can cover more ground to find the signal and Tommy. Plus, we can watch each other's backs.
Alright, I'll go with Alice, and then you guys can take the top floor and work your way down.
Tommy! Tommy! Where are you now?
I bet you're really regretting all that killer denial stuff now, huh?
Isn't really the time for that?
I'm just saying, I find it kind of ironic that you're being hunted by the very thing that you thought was fiction.
Hey, I never said there wasn't a killer. Just that I didn't have a horror movie mask on.
Hey, I think I got something.
Great.
Oh my god, Tommy, you're okay!
Yeah, I'm glad you are too.
What happened to you? Why didn't you come back to the studio?
Well, I heard Casey scream and then I went looking for her. Where is everyone?
He got Wes.
Wes is dead?
Tommy? What's that on your hands?
I found Casey. We need to go before he finds us too. Run! Run!
Are you okay?
Why didn't you open the door?
I'm sorry. I just didn't want the killer to get in too.
How does he know the code? Take that mask off. Let's see the face of this monster. Who the hell are you? Are you one of those construction workers or something?
No, Nancy. This is Chuck. Chuck. Meet Nancy.
How could you? We were your friends.
And that's exactly why this all worked out so well. Trust is a very powerful thing, you know. And only friends would trust each other with, say, the details for a date. Or even the passwords to your phones. I mean, come on, it's 2024. Did you seriously think a college campus wouldn't have service? You even trusted me about the doors. You didn't even think to check for yourselves. And plus, a sole survivor makes this a much more interesting story. I can see the headlines now. Brave woman triumphs over killer as only survivor of a night of terror.
What was that headline again?
Sorry, babe, but that's the price of fame. It's a necessary sacrifice to be rocketed to the top.
You're insane!
That may be. But then again, who isn't these days? Now, in order for me to be the sole survivor, I'm going to kindly meet you to die.
Go to hell.
Fine. Have it your way.
She keeps them away, Shonda, in a pretty cabinet. Let them eat cake, she says, just like Marie Antoinette. A building, a remedy for Christophe.